For the first time in his Grand Prix career, Joe Roberts leads the Moto2 World Championship. The 26-year-old American has had a stellar start to the 2024 season, and it comes at such a crucial time too. With the MotoGP class essentially undergoing a contract reset for 2025, so many seats are up for grabs, and there is one team in particular that Joe Roberts has been linked to. After the Spanish Grand Prix, Roberts leads the Moto2 series thanks to solid results and great consistency. It makes him the first American rider to lead a Grand Prix World Championship since the late great Nicky Hayden did at the conclusion of the 2006 season. Joe even leads Moto2 with 69 points at the moment, a coincidental but nice nod to the much-loved and missed Kentucky kid. What's more is that Roberts is the first American to lead the intermediate class standings since John Kaczynski did back in 1990. While Roberts may not have taken victory yet this year, his trio of second places not only make him the first American to take three podiums in a row since Hayden in 2006, but they also show a level of consistency that we haven't seen from Roberts before. And all of those second places have come from grid positions off the front row. The most impressive thing is that his charge just this past weekend in Jerez, where Roberts surged from 11th on the grid to second place, demonstrate a key skill required for the MotoGP class that Joe clearly has: tyre management. And even his lesser surges from 5th to 2nd in both America and Portugal demonstrate it as well. With a change in tyre supplier in Moto2, it was always going to present a different challenge, and it's one that Joe seems to have risen to. Of course, the results that Roberts is achieving this year simply cannot be put down to just a change in tyre supplier. You don't fluke three Grand Prix podiums in a row. Roberts has genuinely elevated his game this year, and it's come at the perfect time. With American team Trackhouse Racing entering MotoGP at the start of this year, there is of course the natural link between Roberts and Trackhouse, and that link has been heavy in 2025 rumour mills in recent weeks. There's no doubt that if Roberts can keep his current form, he'll be in the conversation for Trackhouse's future plans, but as with all MotoGP seats, for each seat there is, there are three or more riders wanting the opportunity too. The big thing is that, of course, Trackhouse Racing have two very capable riders already in the form of Miguel Oliveira and Raul Fernandez. Oliveira's pedigree needs little introduction.
Miguel Oliveira has won an unbelievable Styrian Grand Prix.
A five-time race winner in MotoGP and two further podiums as well, Oliveira has proven he has that top level of talent to do great things. While things at the moment aren't going the smoothest for Miguel, there's no doubt that when he gets comfortable with the 2024 Aprilia RSGP, he'll be well capable of securing standout results. On the other side of the garage, Raul Fernandez only seems to be getting stronger and growing into the class. For a rider that had such a stunning Moto2 season, perhaps his start in MotoGP hasn't been what many expected. But now, in his third season, he's making inroads into securing frequent top tens, and that's no mean feat in the most competitive field in MotoGP history, while also riding a year-old machine. Inevitably, it's already happened. The 2025 rumour mill is already well underway, but for the riders in the conversation, keeping their focus on the here and now is critical. Joe Roberts' start to the year has been impressive. He's quite clearly elevated his game from last season, and that might just reward him with a shot at the most prestigious class in motorcycle racing for 2025. If that does happen, it'll be the start of the next chapter in American Grand Prix riders and end a decade-long hiatus of a full-time American MotoGP racer.
If you enjoyed that, there's plenty more to come. See you on track.